Now, when your parents come to you and say, "Hey, we're going to take you to a party," I know what your first question is. You ask, "Are there going to be other kids there?" Because what you really want to know is this going to be a kids' party or a boring adults' party? Now, you don't actually care how many kids are going to be there. You just want to make sure there are going to be more kids than adults. Because if there are more kids than adults, then you can turn it into a kids' party. What you really care about is the ratio of kids to adults. Now, I'm going to explain what a ratio is with a problem. Here's our problem. Ratio of kids to adults at a party is 5:2. I don't like saying colon over and over. That reminds me of body parts. So I'm going to pronounce this as 5:2. And that's the ratio. What that ratio means is that for every 5 kids at the party, there are 2 adults at the party. Doesn't tell us how many people are at the party. Doesn't tell us how many kids there are. Doesn't tell us how many adults there are. Just tells us that for every 5 kids, there are 2 adults. We can put everyone in the party in groups. And each of those groups will have 5 kids, 2 adults. That's all this ratio tells us. Doesn't tell us how many groups there are. Let's read the rest of the problem here. It says, if there are 14 adults at the party, then how many kids are there? So our ratio here tells us that we have 5 kids for every 2 adults. Now, we could just have 5 kids and 2 adults and that's it. Or we could have 2 of those groups. If we had 2 of those groups, well, then we'd have 2 times 5 kids and 2 times 2 adults. And all we're doing here is multiplying each of these components, each of these parts of the ratio by 2. So if we had 2 of these groups, that will give us 10:4. 10 kids, 4 adults. 4 isn't 14. In order to get to 14 adults, well, we need 7 of these groups. 7 of these groups of 2. So we can take our ratio and again multiply both parts by the same number. Multiply them both by 7 now. It's like taking 7 of these groups. And we get 35:14. 14 adults, 35 kids. So we've answered the problem. We know there are 35 kids at the party. What we're doing here is we're taking the ratio. We're multiplying both parts of the ratio by the same number. And that gives us an equivalent ratio. We found a ratio here that has 14 adults. That's what we need. So the other part is the kids is 35. Now, this is just one way to think about ratios. We're going to see a lot of different ways to think about ratios. One other way to think about this is if we have 5:2 kids to adults, that means in every group, we can put them in groups, we'll have 5 kids and 2 adults. Now, imagine we have x of these groups. If we have x of these groups, then we have 5x kids, because there are 5 kids in each of these groups, and we have 2x adults. And once again, 2x equals 14. That means x is 7. Put 7 in here. 5 times 7 is 35. We get 35 kids once again. Let's take a look at another ratio problem. Here we have kids to adults at a different parties. The ratio is 3:5. That means for every 3 kids, there are 5 adults. This is going to be a boring party. If there are 26 more adults than kids, then how many kids are at the party? Let's approach this like we did the first problem. Just think about these groups here. In each group, we have 3 kids and 5 adults. 3 kids and 5 adults. That means each of these groups has 2 more adults than kids. Now, in total, I need 26 more adults. But one of these groups has 2. So if I had 2 of these groups, that would give me 6 kids and 10 adults. That difference would be 4. 3 of these groups, the difference would be 6. 4 of these groups, and so on. So in each of these groups, I have 2 more adults than kids. I need a total of 26 more adults. That means I need 13 groups. 13 of these groups. Let's check that. Make sure we did that right. 3:5. If I have 13 of these groups, I multiply both parts by 13. 13 times 3 is 39. 13 times 5 is 65. Sure enough, 65 is 26 more than 39. So there are 39 kids at the party. Now, another way we can do this, let's go back and look at the second way. The second way we did this problem, putting in the x, we'll come back to our second problem. If our ratio of kids to adults is 3:5, and we have, say, x of these groups, that means we have 3x kids and 5x adults. Again, that's just because we can take this ratio and make an equivalent ratio by multiplying it by any number. Up here we multiplied it by 13. Down here we're multiplying it by x. And what we're told is that there are 26 more adults than kids. We're told that 5x minus 3x equals 26. 5x minus 3x, of course, that's 2x. 2x equals 26. Divide by 2, we get x equals 13. Stick the 13 back in here. 3 times 13 is once again 39. We've done the same problem two different ways. Got the same answer. Here we have 3x kids is 39 kids. Got the same answer two different ways. We must be right, so we're done.